ketika umat Islam di Timur bercakaran mengenai isu kafir-mengafir, ada jemaat di barat ini yang bertungkus lumus untuk menyebarkan Islam di negara barat. Tidak lain tidak bukan kelompok ini adalah jemaat Ahmadiyah yang memperlihatkan keindahan Islam dengan cara yang berbeza. Mereka menggunakan jihad intelektual untuk mengislamkan masyarakat barat. Berbagai aktiviti dakwah dijalankan oleh mereka. Mereka mencetak Al-Quran dalam berbagai bahasa. Mereka mengadakan perjumpaan seperti ini, iaitu dikenali sebagai jasa sarana. Dan mereka membuat iklan di bas-bas di UK yang menunjukkan tentang agama Islam adalah agama yang cintakan kedamaian. Kalau kita dapat lihat bahawa pada dalam pertemuan jasa sarana inilah, masyarakat barat atau di UK ini dibawa untuk berkenalan dengan apa itu Islam. Mereka akan diberikan pendedahan tentang keindahan Islam, keindahan Al-Quran dan kemuliaan Nabi Muhammad SAW. Pada jasa sarana ini, mereka meletakkan bendera di lapangan ini, di mana setiap bendera ini memperlihatkan bahawa negara-negara yang jemaah Ahmadiyah sudah berdiri. Sama ada mereka menghantar mubaligh mereka di sana, memberikan rumah misi ataupun mereka sudah membina masjid di sana. Inilah yang dilakukan oleh jemaah Ahmadiyah untuk menyebarkan Islam ke seluruh pelosok dunia.
On the authority of the Holy Quran, the promised Messiah, the founder of the community, he made this point very clear, which was a big news for people. Many people thought it very difficult to believe, but once they pondered over those verses of the Holy Quran which the founder of the community presented before them, it was quite clear for them that first thing for is that Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, did not actually die on the cross. He proved it from so many verses of the Holy Quran, and he made it very clear for everybody that he was no doubt put on the cross, as the history tells us. He was nailed to the cross. He stayed there for a couple of hours or more, but he actually did not die on the cross.
Biblical scripture is very clear. He did not die. I mean, it's clearly written in the New Testament. If you follow it carefully, from the Gospel of Matthew and other Gospels, he survived that cross.
As a former Christian, I believe that God had put His Son on the cross, and I used to think, what type of father would kill his son just for the sake of someone else's sins? And when I read the book of the Promised Messiah, Islam, I felt such an overwhelming sense of relief that he didn't die on that cross. And he produced biblical evidence to say that he didn't die on the cross, not his own evidence. You know, he was taken down from the cross after only 3 hours on the cross. Normally, from when you research on crucifixion, a very fit young man like Jesus was at the time, I think he was staying on the cross for a number of days. But because that day was the Sabbath day, he had to be taken down the cross before the sunset.
Medically speaking, he wouldn't have died on the cross in 3 to 4 hours. Because in the olden days, they used to put these criminals on the cross for even few days, at least 24 to 48 hours. Secondly, they used to break their bones, you know, the two robbers on his side. Their bones were broken, but Jesus Christ's bones were not broken.
When the soldier, you know, pierced his side with his spear, out gushed the water, the blood, which normally you don't get off a dead body.
It is medically proven that if a person is dead, his blood clots and it doesn't remain liquid or fluid. So if he was dead, the blood and water wouldn't have come out.
He was taken down, his legs weren't broken like his other two people who were crucified with him. And he was taken into a cave. He was administered to by a doctor, Nicodemus. He was a physician who anointed his wounds. The whip marks on his back and the crucifixion wounds, and the wounds on his head from the thorns.
فَقَدْ بَلَّغْتُ فَرْضِي.